What would you say if I told you that the learning success of your students only depends on the actions that your students are doing and not what you do? And how would you feel if there would be no guarantee, in principle, that you can successfully convey your understanding and your representations of a concept to the students? Well, these and similar claims can be found in constructivism, a learning paradigm also stemming from the last century. Constructivists analyzed the circumstances of learning and extended learning by including variables such as the body, social aspects, and the individual history of learners. Constructivists presume that the act of learning and knowing is a highly constructive and individual one. They go even so far as to claim that in the act of knowing, it is the human mind that actively gives meaning and order to that reality to which it is responding. By that, questioning structures independent of an observer and any form of direct realism. They envision learning as a rich and complex phenomenon of subjects and contexts. It is co-created by the learners and the interaction with their materials, and thus cannot be condensed in a mere set of input-output relations. It is a social construct. In addition, learning necessitates an acting body and being situated in a concrete space of things and experiences. And no two subjects are exactly the same. Every individual goes through its own and unique learning process, shaped by prior experiences, values, and idiosyncrasies. Constructivists also claim that forming representations is a highly creative and constructive act, using the building blocks of prior knowledge that are only available to the individual subject at this point in time. So there is no value in experts trying to educate or to teach their students. Rather, it is the subject that has the sole responsibility over its learning. The instructor should move from the sage on the stage to the guide by the side and merely try to remove potential obstacles for the learners. It is thus not easy to coalesce this learning paradigm into a short formula. At best, learning is conceptualized as a holistic and collaborative process. If we try to put the constructivist claims to the test, we find that the idea of knowledge acquisition as a constructive process to be sound, yet hardly new or original. Constructivist theories can inform researchers and practitioners with regards to the value and importance of social and bodily aspects of learning. The notion that learners should be left undisturbed by the instructor only holds true if the learner already has a substantial amount of expertise in a field. Novice learners still need an expert to structure their learning and provide model reasoning and explaining. And the radical autopoiesis conjecture, namely, that the brain is an informationally closed system, is fairly problematic. It is in itself inconsistent and is rather a philosophical stance than a viable presupposition for research. Constructivism still enjoys a lot of popularity among learning scientists and instructors, as it has expanded the spectrum of teaching frameworks. Formats such as self-regulated learning, discovery-based learning, problem-based learning, and collaborative learning are effective modes of modern teaching. It also offers novel environments for example giving, case studies, project work, learning portfolio, and learning journals. Maybe this brief discourse convinced you to apply and implement a constructivist intervention in one of your lectures. If you want to, get in touch with us and we'll gladly discuss the pros and cons of this approach. Take care. Goodbye.